Yo, let's talk about Malignant. What the fuck is going on? Not what I was expecting at all, and I don't know if that's a good thing or what, but here we are, James Wan 2021 giving us a B movie to become a cult classic, I feel. So this is the movie that came out on HBO Max, also came out in theaters, and let me tell you, the hype for this movie, in my honest opinion, for me, was high. How do I feel after it? I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it exactly. I do think it's interesting, however, and I do want to talk about it though. Pretty much this movie follows from the beginning, leaves you pretty much wondering what the hell's going on, like what's real, what's not. But we know that this movie deals with a woman who is like in an abusive relationship, it seems. She's always having miscarriages, and then one day her husband actually knocks her against the wall and she starts to bleed. And then the husband actually ends up dying after he's killed by a force. And that's one of the things. At first, you're thinking, is this like some imagination thing, some spirit or something? But then we actually see that this being, whatever thing that's killing people, is actually tying back to the beginning of the film where we saw this new doctors trying to calm a psychiatric patient that they named Gabriel. And now we know that this is who's actually doing the killings here. We see that there is a connection with our main character as well, who had been having the miscarriages. We find out that she had actually been adopted, and she actually starts to realize that she has some connection to Gabriel in the past as well, and everything's leading back to her. Eventually, we do see Gabriel kidnap a woman that's giving tours, and after some time, we realize that this woman is the mother of Gabriel, as well as our main protagonist, Emily Madison, whatever you want to call her. And she had actually given Madison up for adoption. Gabriel apparently had died or been absorbed. That's what we were led to believe. But then we realized towards the end of it that Gabriel is pretty much alive. And so I think this movie liked to twist you around a lot. It made you want to think that maybe it was all in her imagination and she was actually doing the killing, and that was just her way of projecting things. Or what exactly was going on? Was there some supernatural like phenomenon called Gabriel that was doing all of this as well? Turns out, yeah, it's none of that, because the movie, and as many people have pointed out, that third act just gets insane and it turns into some insanity that I've never seen in theaters in any movie, I think, before, which is why I don't hate this movie. Even though some of the stuff on here did sound cheesy, like the dialogue and all of that, it is a great B-horror film that I think will be a cult classic for sure. And so what actually is happening here is, once the husband actually pushed Madison, and that opened pretty much her evil twin Gabriel that she had attached to her all the time, that the doctors had actually pretty much put away back in 93, and Gabriel came out for revenge once he was unleashed again. And so he's able to actually take control of her whole body and become this sort of like ninja monster, whatever you want to call it. It moves creepily and pretty much blanks around. So a very, very interesting scene once Gabriel's full form comes out, where we see Madison's face just go blank because she's not in control anymore, and Gabriel's on the other side, so the hands have to like twist out, and it's just something that's insane to see. And let me tell you, I think that Gabriel can take on Batman. There's no doubt about that. The way this man was moving, it was insane. So we see all of this happening, and Gabriel is just on a rampage killing people, and eventually he is trying to kill the mother as well and the sister. However, what happens here is that Emily Madison, whatever you want to call her, ends up coming out and taking control back of her body, doesn't let this happen, and she's just like, I am going to lock you back up in my brain, and I'm not going to let you do any of this. You are the reason for all of my miscarriages because you were feeding off of fetuses, and I'm not gonna allow this no more. And eventually, we see her do this, locked Gabriel in the cage, and that was it. So, I don't know. A very, very interesting film here, because I feel it was very much so a movie that was meant to be like insane and just a B-side plot. Like, I feel like James Wan always wanted to make this movie, and then he got big after Saw. Not exactly this movie, you know, but a movie just like this, like something very much so feeling like a Pulp Fiction type of thing, where it's something that you read in a comic and you know it's like trashy and like, you know, but it's still good at the same time. It's so bad it's good in a way. The twist definitely left me going like, what the fuck, out loud. So I thought it was great the way it was done, and I wasn't too pissed off about some of the things we saw of what I think is a film. And I wasn't too like disappointed when a film, like when some films do things that feel so whack or out of character and all of this, with this one, because the intention felt that way, in my honest opinion. It sort of gave me some Scream vibes at a point where it felt very satirical at some sort of genre, but that could just be me reaching, right? But nonetheless, I think that we are definitely setting ourselves up for future movies, which they have talked about. I'll talk about that in another video coming up this weekend. But pretty much that's it. Gabriel was pretty much awoken after all of that. And like they said, he had garnered enough strength after eating the fetuses that he was able to just take on the form himself and do all of these killings as well. So very interesting how this will play into the future as well of the franchise. If this becomes a franchise, we'll have to see how it does, as well as the second go about at the box office, because I feel like a lot of people will say, don't go watch this trash. Now, it is very mixed reviews on Rotten Tomatoes and other places as well, pretty much holding an average of a 60. So I don't know if second time box office next week is going to do as hot as this one. I know that James Wan attaching his name to this definitely is going to get the hype for the beginning, and that was me. I was excited to see what he had cooked up. Apparently wasn't written by him and all of that as well either, so I don't know what's going on here. But like I said, I thought it was interesting, it was funny, it was entertaining to say the least. So I'd be here to see what they want to do with this franchise, where they want to take Gabriel next. But as I said, it was a fun time, and what could the sequel be? We'll talk about that in another video. But what are your thoughts on Malignant and the twists and turns all about? Let me know in the comments down below, because I'm really interested in knowing what people think about this movie, because it was just pure insanity. Anyways, as always, that is going to do it for me. Haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you turn on that bell for notifications. Make sure that you give this video a thumbs up, comment down your thoughts, and follow me on TikTok and Twitter, all that good stuff. As always, that is going to do it for me. Check out the video on the left if you haven't already. Make sure you subscribe. I'll see you next time. Stay safe, stay positive.